Flight 229, you're clear for takeoff.
Fix finally here, it's about time to see what's next in store for us at Asobo. Before we begin, welcome to the channel. If you haven't subscribed yet and if this is your first time, go ahead and hit the subscribe button for future releases on flight simming, development updates, third-party add-ons, absolutely anything that's related to flight simming, you've come to the right place. Sim Update 3 is next in line for a large number of fixes. We'll discuss today on what's new at Asobo, development updates, marketplace news, calendar events, and a free add-on at the end. So make sure you stick around. With the latest fix in place, the flaps issue with other fixes based on photogrammetry have been resolved. Looking at the development update this week, it appears that the Sim Update 3 will be planned for its release next week, that's the 11th of March. Work has already begun for the upcoming patch, and we ought to look forward for the next world update 4, which is Benelux. Asobo isn't just working on getting fixes for this region, rather they're keen on joining hands with other airlines in the region. Very recently, they mentioned on their plans towards discussions with Air France, KLM, and several other airlines in the region, trying to convince them if Asobo could update featuring those countries. In regards to the Sim Update 3, a lot of Garmin improvements would be in place with the help of the team who have been working towards this area. Asobo wants to not just control their product in the most effective manner, they want it to be a universal one with the help of different collaborators. At the moment, roads, bridges are yet to be in place on a global scale in the simulator. However, they are keen on letting the partners take charge of items such as bridges and other related structures like procedural buildings which appear. This transparency can benefit greatly towards the simulator ultimately being a more engaging product. With the impact of aviation being enormous in the 20th century, the sim is moving towards the lines of serious business. At the current trend of the feedback snapshot, the main priority would be focused on the Garmin fixes that would be addressed on Sim Update 3. Live weather, wind readings, and other top items in the update, along with glowing aircraft and objects, would be included, and these are the main items for the upcoming Sim Update 3. This is going live next week, and the team of Asobo are busy testing this fix, trying to make sure of any last minute items before they release it. Following the wishlist, items appear to be in the same lines as of last week. We expect to see several other items that can be added in the list in the coming days. Right now, some of the items that are new include helicopters, other regions that can be focused on the world update aspects and more. Under the VR section of the wishlist, new items have been added towards hardware support that can very well welcome additional brands of headsets and external chart view capacities. There have been few changes towards the software development kit where issues related to fonts under dev mode have been fixed. A bug which was found recently under the scenery editor have been fixed, which was related to object test radius. It appears that the development mode have shown some changes with the recent implementation of new areas supporting individual points on polygon-based objects during the stages of development. Looking at the WASM module, there have been fixes towards the security aspect under some areas. It's good to see interest go towards the simulator, not on the ground level which contain the aircrafts or airports, it's rather on the highest level trying to make changes towards the code that can smoothen the experience and add much more collaborations and ideas within the simulator. To give you a very good example, the recent appearance of coastline add-ons with boats from seafront simulations is a good start. These are the things that can make a difference in flight simming. Talking about the marketplace, the items appear to be growing on a weekly basis, which is always good news. Just Flight's Piper Arrow 3 is available now. A home development product which appears to be highly detailed with good amount of features. We are right now in the process of reviewing this beautiful bird, so do stay tuned for the upcoming review by subscribing to our channel. Aerosoft, another leader in the development world, have announced their pilot aircraft for the simulator, the CRJ series. It's to be released on the 16th of this month, and with a considerable amount of time spent on research and development, this is ought to be in the minds of most users. Likewise, other developers are working on different line of products that can add further excitement towards flight simming. Under the airports section, so far we have 636 airports, wherein 36 new airports were added last week. At the same time, as mentioned with the newly introduced aircrafts, we have a combined total of 120 aircrafts which are either released or in development. You can now find 223 sceneries in the simulator along with 20 missions where new 3 mission packs were added last week. One thing to note is that the marketplace alone isn't the place to find all these products, as several developers have their products placed in their own websites, so keep that in mind. While most of the products have been approved by Microsoft, the marketplace is yet to be growing within its own space, trying to welcome all new products in a single store. And that's the reason we have many other platforms which sell third-party add-ons, which include SimMarket, developer websites like orbixdirect.com or airsoft.com. So hopefully, we find that the marketplace can accommodate all these add-ons pretty much soon. Speaking of our own community, we welcome back Paul, who's been feeling great after his hospital visit. Hope you're doing very well, sir. Julian Ingham, Andy Beckett, and Flying Spud, what part of the UK are you flying, mates? And a question to all you guys out there, what is your favorite location at the UK? Do share them in the comments, and we would love to hear from you. The community events are right here, the month of March that appears occupied, at least for this week. Another adventure comes from the famous gang Aussie Group Flights team. It's a gorgeous part of the UK, a majestic trip rather to visit these historic castles and lochs in the country of Scotland. The plan is to begin from Procton, which is the EG29 in short located at Northern Scotland. You get to see many castles and lochs on the way. With the latest patch of World Update 3, the views can't be much more breathtaking, and the tour ends in Newcastle. I'll include the links to this event below, where you can find all the details, which include nav map, flight plan, timings, Discord server, and any other further instructions. So kudos to this gang for creating interesting events on a weekly basis. The section of freebies are here, an interesting one, but something unique. Some of you have been asking about choppers over the months and curious to see what's in store in Microsoft. Well, this isn't official, rather an add-on prepared by fellow developers who are interested to take flight simming to a different level. The Airbus H135 Heli project, a decent add-on, quite frankly, which was very recently released to the simulator, and a successful one. A team of handful of members have taken time to develop this, quite a few members by the way, and thanks to Faroe Steve and his entire team for this, folks. This is a great effort to make this quality add-on. So it's a free add-on. The link for this free download can be found in the description below. One thing to note about add-ons like these is that the right settings have to be in place. So make sure that you have the settings changed to legacy mode if you'd like to use aircrafts like these. Well, we certainly hope you liked this video. Do hit that thumbs up button, folks. Subscribe for more updates coming along the way. This is just the beginning for Microsoft Flight Simulator. We hope you have a beautiful rest of the day. So stay tuned and take care.